Hey everyone, it's Isaac, and I'm here to let you know that I actually started a Kickstarter for my new book and film. I'm super excited about it. I want you to go check it out right now in the link in my description here. And there's awesome rewards. The book is, and the film is about building father-son relationships. And even if you're not a father or a son, I think this is something really important to get involved with and encourage and support. So I'm super excited about the project, and I love it. No matter who you are, get involved. Okay, I'll see you there. Hey guys, what's up? It's Isaac again, and welcome back to the Daily Disciple channel. Today, we're going to be talking about four things to look for in a potential spouse. Now, disclaimer, nobody does any of these things perfectly. You're not going to find a perfect person. So by me telling you these things to look for, I'm not saying that you need to find a person that meets every single character quality on this list, or maybe even a character quality on your list. It's important to have those things in mind that we're saying, okay, you know what? I'm looking for a person that kind of meets these kind of character qualities. But it's also important to have in mind that you're not going to meet somebody that fits those perfectly. That's just a small disclaimer as we're going into this topic. Anyway, let's get into it. Now, the first thing is to look for someone who doesn't depend on you for their self-worth. Now, what is self-worth? It's our worth that is intrinsic, that is given to us by God. God places worth on us. And we each have that individually. But all of a sudden, when people start kind of becoming clingy or needy of someone they're in a relationship with, that self-worth, you need that other person to constantly affirm you, constantly help you, constantly, it's this kind of what you might put in terms of a codependent relationship. And that's not a healthy thing. That's not something that we should be looking for. And it's not biblical too. We ought to have a distinct and biblical sense of our self-worth as individuals. Not that we're getting that from other people, but that we can get that from God. And that's one thing that I think you should keep in mind. Now on to number two. Now number two is look for someone who sees a relationship as an avenue to love you, not control you. Some people just go into relationships with this idea that, oh, this is going to be fun to kind of be together and be in a relationship. But also there's just kind of a sense that, hey, look, I have some say in how you live your life. I have control over you. And a lot of guys, honestly, can get into this kind of unhealthy relationships where they just are, you know, either bossing around their girlfriends or girlfriends bossing around their boyfriends. It's not a healthy thing to have this this controlling nature as opposed to wanting the best for them and love, right? Having that love and everything pour out of that kind of, hey, look, I want what's best for you because I love you, instead of I want to control you because that's gonna fuel what I want the most, you know? There's a difference there, and I think it's important that we watch out for not entering a relationship with someone who just wants to control us. Rather, look for someone that wants to love in the midst of that relationship. That's number two. Number three is look for someone who is committed to the relationship with the potential of marriage, not just someone who's trying to get into a relationship to get rid of loneliness. And I think this can be a real tendency to jump into a relationship when you're not ready, when you're not ready emotionally, spiritually, financially. There's a lot of things that need to come into place before you're ready to enter a relationship. And a lot of people don't because don't get ready, aren't prepared when they enter a relationship just because they want to escape this loneliness. And if you're with somebody that just wants to escape loneliness but really has no mindset of looking forward to marriage, it can be a tough thing. Because one person's just about, hey, let's hang out, let's have all the fun stuff associated with a relationship, and that, you know, it quenches this loneliness, but yet it's not really heading towards anything. And it's important that we keep our eyes open for that and look for someone that is committed to the relationship as possibly heading towards marriage, as opposed to just, just something to quench temporal loneliness. It's important that we do that. Number four, and what I think is most important, is look for someone who loves God more than you. And you're like, What? Why would I want that? I want them to love me. I want them to love me so much. When our spouse or our girlfriend or boyfriend, whatever, when they're depending on us, when they love us the most, and they put that kind of, they see us as the top, right? If we're on the top, they love us the most. It's not a healthy place to be for them, because then they have their priorities mixed up. God should be at the top of all our priorities and our love, because our love for others is that which flows out of our love for God. We can only love other people. We can only love our spouse or potential spouse based on the love that we have for God. It flows out of that into loving other people. And if you have that the wrong way, you're not going to be able to love well. A Christ-like love comes out of a love for Christ. See, you should be looking for someone who wants to fulfill God's desires as opposed to fulfilling your desires. Because God's desires are so much better, so much higher, so much wiser, so much properly oriented than yours. If your spouse is just all about pleasing you, doing everything for you, that's not going to be beneficial to you because your desires may be messed up. But if the person that we're in a relationship with is committed to loving God the most and doing what God wants, that ultimately is going to be the best thing, not only for our relationship, but for her relationship with God and mine as well. These two things work in tandem. And that's why I think it's very important that you find someone that loves God more than they love you. That doesn't mean they don't like you. That doesn't mean they don't love you. But it's about where our priorities are. And God should always be on the top of our priorities. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you kind of, maybe you gained something from this video. These are just some of my thoughts. I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments down below. If you're interested in more videos like this, be sure to subscribe. If you like this video, give it a like. And I guess I'll see you guys next week. See you later.